G'day, it's Ashman here at the 2012 Imagine Cup Worldwide Finals here in Sydney, celebrating the 10th anniversary. And I'm here with Ed Hooper, and you're a past winner of the Imagine Cup. And your experience at the Imagine Cup as a participant, what did you gain?
Ash, I gained life skills that that I've used every day since the competition. So a couple of years ago, I got some friends. We made a software design project that helped farmers use technology to save the water on their farms. And then from doing that, we learnt, you know, all the way from just a concept in our head, how to turn that into a business. And we ended up pitching to investors. We ended up getting to deal with media. You know, we built a product and actually got to see people who are non-technical technical use it. And, you know, this is great. And all these things I've gone to use in my career since then. And it's just so exciting to be here and see what all these students from all over the world, just to see them doing the same thing.
Great. And I guess, well, since winning and getting all the publicity from that, what have you done using that and building upon that until now?
So after winning the competition, I've had the opportunity to travel quite a bit. I spent some time studying in the US, and I got to visit a lot of schools around the world and actually share, you know, some of the insights I got from being involved in the Imagine Cup. And then I went down the route of working for a big company, and then now I'm doing a startup with some of the guys that actually were in my original Imagine Cup team, and we're going through the fundraising process at the moment. And once again, those Imagine Cup skills are being used again there.
Wow, it seems like it actually really took off from that Imagine Cup win in 2008. And I guess, how would you compare that experience as a participant to being a judge now?
Being a judge, it's quite different because the whole event is about the students. So my whole capacity over the last few days and over the time ahead is just to make sure that these students have the best experience, and that, you know, we can see what they've done, we can adequately assess it, and, you know, make sure the best project wins.
Of course. And are you seeing any key themes? Because obviously this time you get to see all of the entrants. So is there anything which you've noticed which is consistent throughout these teams this year?
Definitely the passion. So, I mean, when we did our project, I was out on a farm one day and I saw that these farmers were doing it tough and didn't have enough water. And then now I'm seeing, you know, projects from South America where, you know, someone's had a friend that's had Down syndrome, so they've come up with an amazing piece of technology so they can, you know, help their friend learn. And just seeing these guys, you know, discover problems, not know anything about them, and then, you know, get the technology that's available to them and then solve them is just, it's amazing.
Great. And what about technology being used? Is there a trend which you're seeing within these teams?
Look, I think every year there's a couple of hot pieces of technology that come out that everyone likes to make use of. So this year we're seeing a lot of Kinect. A few years ago we were seeing a lot of cloud when Windows Azure was released. Yep. But it's I guess you need to still use what solves the problem at hand. And there's a whole range of different technologies that everyone's been using. And besides the Kinect, not that many are standing out.
Okay, and before we leave, are there any tips or advice which you would give to this year's Imagine Cup participants?
After the competition ends, don't stop there. Keep going. You know, these projects can turn into real businesses. If you look at the alumni of the competition, each year there's a couple of projects that actually, you know, these guys go on and they pivot and they end up doing something else, or they actually, you know, start with the idea they had and turn it into reality, and that can be you guys. So, you know, you've done really well to get this far, but, you know, whether you win or whatever the outcome, just keep going, because the work that everyone's been doing is great and there's so much potential.
Well, thank you, Ed, for